Is just breaking, could be very big indeed. New word coming in the Russia investigation. A motion filed by special counsel Robert Mueller concerning Paul Manafort, former Trump campaign chairman, already charged with a long list of alleged crimes. Mueller's office is accusing Manafort of attempting to tamper with witnesses, and they're asking the court to revoke his bond as well as his house arrest. CNN's Sarah Murray just got hold of the actual filing. She's going through it now. Sarah, what's the headline here?
Well, that's right. The headline is basically what you pointed out. The special counsel's office certainly not very happy with Paul Manafort. A special counsel prosecutors allege that Manafort was attempting to tamper with potential witnesses while on pretrial release and accordingly has violated the conditions of his release. Now, remember, Paul Manafort has been on house arrest. As part of this, the special counsel's office is basically seeking to pull back on his house arrest and possibly send him to jail. In this filing, they're calling for the court to have a hearing on this issue as soon as possible. Like I said, Anderson, we're still looking through this filing to glean any details about exactly what the special counsel's office alleges that Paul Manafort did. The witnesses in question are not named in this filing, so we're going to dig through this a little bit more and bring as much news to you as we possibly can. But obviously, this is a huge allegation from the special counsel's office when it comes to Paul Manafort's case. He has insisted over and over again that he is not guilty. So far, he's resisted any kind of effort to strike a plea deal like his partner Rick Gates did.
Yeah, I should point out we have the filing here, and I think it's some 90 pages. So I know you have a lot to go through. There's still details to learn. So we'll continue to check in with you throughout the night. I'll let you get back to reading the documents and your team. David Gergen is here with us. Also on the phone is seen as legal analyst Carrie Cordero. David Gergen, I mean, this is pretty significant. Again, we don't know a lot of the details here. This is just breaking. We just got this this filing. But if Mueller is asking for Manafort to revoke his bail, that's significant.
It's not only about revoking his bail. The allegations, and we've only had a chance to scan some pages of this 90-page report briefing, is basically after being charged with several crimes, federal crimes, he has committed new crimes. That's the allegation by witness tampering. That's a very serious charge. You go to jail for a long time. It also suggests if it's witness tampering, there's a huge cover-up underway by Manafort, at least. We don't know if that touches upon the president or anything like that. It's way too early to tell. But this briefing suggests there are at least three or four people involved in the witness tampering efforts.
And Carrie Cordero, we should also point out, I mean, Rick Gates, who's Manafort's sort of right-hand person, has already made a deal. I believe his former son-in-law has also made a deal. So there's certainly a lot of folks lined up against Manafort who are cooperating with Mueller.
There are, and certainly he's been under pressure to cooperate as well. I think we have to look at this, you know, and I haven't had a chance to look all through this document yet as well, but I think we have to look at this in the context of everything else that we're seeing play out in the public domain. In other words, if behind the scenes the special counsel's office has been learning that Manafort has been trying to pressure or interfere with the investigation, further obstruct, tamper with witnesses, there is a significant possibility, and again, I'm extrapolating from what we're hearing so far, but there's a significant possibility that the president's legal team has gotten wind of some of this as well. And some of the activity that we've been hearing about pardons, about just sort of the general, the statements that are coming out of the president and his Twitter feed, I think we have to take it all in context together, that there is a lot going on behind the scenes that insiders know about that are feeding into some of all of the public activity we've been seeing.
So wait, Carrie, you're saying it's possible that the president's legal team was aware in advance of these allegations by Mueller?
I'm just saying I don't know what they would have known in advance, but what I'm trying to say is that it is possible if this ongoing investigation was going on that they could get wind of different activities that are going on. For example, if Manafort is reaching out to different people in the Trump campaign orbit, we don't know who, you know, I haven't read the document yet, so I don't know who he is alleged to have been tampering with. But it's just possible that different pieces of the investigation can press on other parts and that some of this may end up being connected.
Right. Also, Jeff Toobin is joining us on the phone. We should also point out, Jeff, to Carrie's point, we don't know who he may have been trying to tamper with, according to the government. May have not been anybody in the administration, might have been people in his business past. You know, it's hard to imagine that he would have much access to anybody now in the administration or formerly in the campaign, Jeff.
Well, that's right. And remember that the charges against Manafort do not relate to his involvement in the 2016 campaign. He is he's charged in relation to his lobbying efforts and his on behalf of Ukrainian interests who are allied with Russia, but they are not directly related to the campaign.
Jeff, I'm just getting word that Sarah Murray also has just gotten some more information out of this, so I just want to quickly go back to her. Sarah, what have you learned?
Well, we're looking through these filings, and it basically said that Manafort had repeatedly contacted two people who worked and previously assisted in lobbying and PR efforts when it came to his work for Ukrainian politicians, as Jeffrey Toobin was just laying out. And according to the filing, Manafort sought to secure materially false testimony concerning the activities of, this is an influential group of European leaders called the Habsburg Group. This had to do with his Ukrainian lobbying. So this seems to be sort of what these prosecutors are alleging, some of these witnesses that he tried to continue contacting. And it says he was continually in contact with these folks even as these superseding indictments were coming out. Again, this seems to have to do with his work with Ukrainian lobbying more so than anything directly to do with the campaign, but we're still digging into this, so we'll bring you any new details as
we
get them.
David Gergen, Kerry Cordero, Jeff Toobin, thanks very much.